western part of India, inherited with different arts and culture from its early period. Among those beautiful cultures, Tanta is one of the unique, especially for the Mithaist, the indigenous people of Manipur. Tanta, which literally means short and spare, is believed to originate from that period when man mingled with gods. It is an art based on discipline, an art which our forefathers used while hunting as well as in the battlefield. Many a battle was fought with our neighbors Kaki and Awa, presently known as the Myanmar, and in each of them, it was the art of Tangta that came to their aid. Our ancestors also used it in their battle against the British, whose empire is said to have known no sunset. Tangta thrived most when Manipur was a monarchical state. From that period onwards, the learning process of Tangta is endlessly flourishing. This art runs in the blood of every Mithai, the indigenous people of Manipur. Before civilization, men used to live in jungles, caves, or wherever they felt convenient. They formed small groups, and these groups used to fight with each other using logs, sticks, etc. They also wrestled with one another. From those days onwards, Saritsara or Mukna, a kind of wrestling-like game, has become the main means of fighting at the time of war. Many books prove that the Mithai kings use it for war and for entertainment as well. We cannot exactly say when Tangta was introduced, but the Mithais believe that it has been practiced since time immemorial. According to some scholars, the method and process of Tangta was first collected and perfected by the king Nongda Lairin Pakhumba, who had learned it from the stories narrated by gods and goddesses. God created fire, water, and air. After this, the soil of 14 layers was created. At last, he formed 19 legs of living beings. Finally, the knowledge of Tangta and Saritsara was introduced. Another story about the origin of Tangta is that during the reign of King Kiamba, a war had to be fought against the Kabus. So he meditated in a cave seeking the blessings of the goddess Ima Lemerel Shidabi to win the war. The goddess appeared in front of him and taught him how to fight using Tangta. She explained the gesture and the movement of the body. Afterward, the king taught this art to each and every person under his rule. Then, the title Mihat Mikol, meaning killing and protection, was given to it. During the reign of King Kagemba, scholars like Apoichamba, Kongnang Thaba taught this system of fighting to the king. Mihat Mikol, Saritsara, and Mukna are a part of Tangta. At one time, Tangta was considered to be a very important branch of education. Each and every person had to know the art of Tangta. Many evidences are found which prove that this art has experienced impressive development during the reign of King Kiamba. His successor had also developed this art of Tangta. Whenever we discuss Tangta, we are reminded of our kings and emperors who had perfected this art. In the present age, education is a must for everybody. Likewise, in the ancient period, every person needed to learn the art of Tangta. From 1891 to 1934, the British government prohibited to practice Tantra. At that time, Maharaja Churachand ruled Manipur under the title of KCSI. The mighty British government feared and loathed this art and they forbade to teach it. Even though the British government tried to abolish the prestigious art from the soil of Manipur, many scholars and learned Manipuris guarded it secretly and with great care. As a result of this, many schools are now established for teaching Tantra. Those persons who wish to learn the art of Tantra have to observe some customary rituals. They have to pray to God and bow to the teacher before practicing the art. They have to choose an auspicious day for learning the prestigious art of Tantra. However, a lot of differences can be seen in the manner and method of Tantra that is found in the present and the past. Nowadays, this art is used only for entertainment and the artist used the custom worn by the Mitais at the time of war and hunting.
Thank you. Hold on.